life. Your life is all about you. All about you. Hi, I'm Reverend Allie Bierman, and you can find me over at metaphysicalministryinternational.com. So, I welcome you to today's gathering of metaphysicalministryinternational.com. What's a metaphysical ministry? Well, it's actually explaining quantum physics. It's how we create our world. And the fact that 99% of what exists in the world, we don't see it, we cannot perceive it, we cannot experience it consciously with our five senses until we're aware of that fact. We begin every week with a happy and grateful share, because when you're happy and you're grateful and you express that to the universe, it just brings you more and more and more for which to feel happy and grateful. So I have a real biggie one here going on. I've had some really nasty parasites inside. One of them was actually salmonella, food poisoning. And it had been locked in some organs. And I've been taking some herbs which caused it to be released. Man, I was really sick for 2 days. But I released it, got rid of it, dumped it out of my system, and boy, do I feel better. So, what is it that you feel happy and grateful for in this moment? I feel happy and grateful for every little thing, and man, my world is filled with things nonstop all day long for which to feel that way. So, what is it all about you? It's all about you and your point of view. Hey, everything in life is really all about you and your point of view. When you look at life, do you see the struggle? Do you see the strife? Or do you see the sunshine? Do you see it's bright? And even through the darkness, do you see the light? Do you see that everything's all right? Because it is, no matter what is going on. It's your choice to wear a smile. It's your choice to eliminate the frown, because it's all about you and your point of view. Everything in life is really all about you. So we each perceive the world in our own unique way. So an event just is. And I decide, or you decide, whether it's happy or sad, whether it's helpful or detrimental, whether it's something we're sharing or something to hide away, whether it's fun or just And when we are aware of the fact that other people aren't seeing the same world that we're seeing, because if you're creating and interpreting events, it's like looking at a whole different reality. It's not like it. It is looking at a whole different reality. When you're aware, you allow yourself to be open to new perspectives. And that gives you an opportunity to grow and change. Let me give you an example from my own life. I was always like really smart. Everything came to me really, really easily. I had lots of talents. I could do lots of things. Anything I wanted to do, anything I set my mind to, I could do it. And I used to teach myself to do it. Well, then I had this major brain injury. I lost a lot of functioning. And a whole lot of that functioning was, well, I lost my short-term memory, which meant if you were talking to me, by the time you started your sentence and by the time you finished your sentence, I had lost the beginning. I was in school working on my doctorate, And I couldn't hold the information. None of it made any sense to me. For the first time in my life, I was struggling to learn things, to know things, to participate. I couldn't participate in conversations. For the first time in my life, I understood this is what it's like for the millions, probably billions of people out there who have challenges with learning. So that was very helpful for me because it brought me into this whole spiritual world and healing world and metaphysical world and allowed me to discover how to heal so that I could then go in and help others to heal. And a very interesting thing happened when I told others the major healing I had done and how I changed my life, and I offered to help them too. It was shocking how many people didn't want to change because they liked their reality the way it was. And hey, if you got a brain injury and you got learning disabilities or physical limitations, man, that's one heck of an excuse for not having to participate when you don't want to. So that's one way that we have differences in how we see the world. Now, here's another example. I know somebody who's colorblind, and we would look at a vehicle. And I'd say, wow, did you see that purple vehicle over there? And he'd say, it's not purple, it's brown. His world saw colors differently. In fact, I would bet if there is a way to get inside my brain and inside your brain so that we could record how you're seeing, say, these greens behind me, I'll bet I'm seeing different shades of green than you are. I love to read. I belong to 5 book groups. And I usually have a very different opinion of the books than the majority of people in the groups. And you know what? I listen to what everybody says about what they liked and what they didn't like. And they listen to what I say. Now I know some of them just look at me with blank stares, but I also know others ask me questions. I'm not out to change anybody else's mind. I'm just out to share my perspective while gathering other people's perspectives, because that way I get to have a different view of something that I otherwise wouldn't be able to appreciate. So why don't you let us know something really big in your life that you really hadn't thought about is really uniquely you? Because here's a secret, everything in your life that you view is your point of view. Even when you share similar opinions to other people, be aware of what's your opinion and your perspective. You can find more information about your spirituality over at metaphysicalministryinternational.com, where you can pick up your own copy of How to Take Your First Steps on Your Spiritual Path. Again, I'm Reverend Allie Bierman, here to assist you on your spiritual journey, because spirituality and religion, two completely different things.